Hey guys, Dr. Matt Nejad here, and I want to talk to you about one of my favorite products for desensitizing teeth. It's from Kuraray, and it's called Teethmate Desensitizer. Before we get started, I just want to say I'm putting a lot of energy into creating high quality educational content, and I really appreciate your support. So please make sure you like, subscribe, and hit the bell for notification so I can keep putting out great content. Teethmate Desensitizer consists of two components. We have the powder, and then we have the liquid. First thing you need to do is determine how much powder you'll need, and there's really two portions here. We have the smaller size portion, which will need one drop of the liquid, and then we have the larger size portion, which will need two drops. Typically, the smaller portion is ideal for one or two teeth, and the larger portion here is more suitable for treating two or more teeth or a quadrant. First thing I'll do is take my powder and gently mix it by turning it over several times to make sure there's no settling of the components. And then I will take a scoop. Now, as you take the scoop, I'm not trying to condense a lot of material in here. I just want to wipe off the excess and do the drop into a mixing well. Now for the liquid again, I want to mix this up and then I want to do exactly one drop. So I'll turn this upside down and then give it a nice size drop. If you don't put enough in there, it's going to be very hard to get the right consistency, which should be a little bit of a thicker paste. And then I like to just use a microbrush to mix it up. And you'll see that it's just enough liquid to make this into a slightly thicker paste, a little on the dry side. And that's the right consistency. When you add it to the teeth, the saliva will actually dilute it down. So you don't want to start with anything more liquidy at this point. First thing you want to do is identify the teeth that are sensitive, and you can either use air and water or just air. I usually start with air and I check tooth by tooth, trying to protect any other teeth so I can kind of narrow down which teeth are going to be the sensitive ones. Let me know if you feel any sensitivity to air when I do this, okay? Mm-hmm. Is that sensitive? Mm-hmm. Okay, now we're gonna check the lateral. Is that sensitive? Mm-hmm. Okay, let's move on to the central. Mm-hmm. Okay, here's the other central. Mm-hmm. Okay, and now we come around. Mm-hmm. That was sensitive? Mm-hmm. Okay, and now also we're gonna check your canine. Okay, so we found two sensitive teeth. We have the lateral and canine. Okay, so now I take this Teethmate, and the tooth doesn't need to be overly dry. If it is too moist, you can wipe it with a gauze. But as long as there isn't too much saliva on there, you can just go ahead and take the Teethmate and gently scrub it in for about 30 seconds to the teeth that you are desensitizing. It's important to really imagine that you are working the calcium phosphate powder here into the open tubules that are causing the sensitivity. And it's very common for people to underdo it. So you want to make sure you're scrubbing it in, getting all around the surface. If you miss any surface that's sensitive, you won't get results. Okay, and then we'll rinse it off and check it again. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and check again. Let me know if you have any sensitivity on these teeth, okay? Okay.
That's less.
It's less? Mm-hmm. You still feel it a little bit though?
It's a lot.
Okay. And let's try the canine as well. Let me hope it's the same thing.
It's not a lot.
Similar? Mm-hmm. Okay. But do you notice a difference than before?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so typically after the first application, what I notice is you end up getting significant enough improvement that the cold sensitivity that you might have with like water would not be noticeable. However, I like to go again until we try to get no noticeable symptom to air, then I'm really confident. So I'm gonna do another application, same exact thing. And the key here is to make sure you're getting all surfaces again. If you miss any surface, you know, if you have to go a little bit subgingival, then you might want to use a different brush that goes. In this case, it doesn't look like we'll need that because we don't have a large defect that looks like it's causing the sensitivity. It's just probably the cervical area here. But if I have any trouble, I'll take a probe or a brush and go subgingival. Again, 30 seconds. You can't really overdo it, but you can definitely underdo it. You can add a little bit more. Okay, let's rinse that off. First of all, was the air and water there sensitive at all?
No.
No, okay. Now let's try the same air blast as before and see if we have any improvement. Do you feel that at all?
Not really.
Okay, and this one?
No.
So it's much better than before? Mm-hmm. Okay. So from there, we could always do a third application if we need to, but usually two or three applications does it for a majority of cases. And if it doesn't, usually I would be looking for a different area or trying to go subgingival to find the area that might be causing the symptoms. But here we have good results with two applications.
Thanks for tuning in. I'm really grateful for all of you watching and supporting my channel. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell for notifications. I plan on putting some really great content out there, and I really appreciate all of you who are making this happen for me. If you're interested in taking one of my courses, you can use the QR code on the screen, and that'll take you to a page where you can join our mailing list for updates, schedule, and more information about the courses. Thank you all.